Ron Radosh, what's wrong with Oliver Stone's history of the United States since World War II?
Well, everything is wrong with what Oliver Stone and Peter Kuznick do in their television history of the United States is completely distort and do not comprehend the real history of the United States and American foreign policy. In their eyes, the United States is a single villain in the world, responsible for the Cold War, for raining atrocity in the Japanese by dropping the atomic bomb, which they claim is totally unnecessary, and that Stalin was a great man of peace who only wanted secure borders and friendly regimes on his borders so that he could build a Soviet Union at peace, while the Truman administration wanted expansionism and war because Truman was a puppet of the military-industrial complex. This is patently absurd. It's contrary to everything we know about the post-war world. In fact, Truman started out trying to fulfill FDR's pledge, assuming there would be a period of friendship with the Soviet Union. And once he got wind of Stalin's actual proven expansionist aims and goals, he had no recourse but to have to protect American national interest and stand up to Stalin's imperial ambitions. This is what caused Truman to change his policy, not because Truman was a fascist and a man of war while Stalin was a humanist and a man of peace. They completely revert the truth about America and its past, thereby harming hundreds, thousands of American students now and in the future. It is a disaster and a disgrace.
Ron, you pointed out in your writing about the history that they seem to have taken a lot of it from a single dubious source.
But they repeat almost verbatim a 1952 book written by a late communist named Karl Marzani, who was an NKVD KGB agent on their payroll, a secret communist who was in the OSS during the war, who wrote a book called We Can Be Friends, the first so-called Cold War revisionist book. They reiterate all the points he made in that book with the same quotes and the same arguments as if we've learned nothing since that book was written in 1952. They ignore all the really good historians who have written about this period and who disagree with their contention. They do not exist. They only use left-wing sources and propaganda to create the historical myth about America. It is a tragedy that a major network bought this and is showing it on television. It is a disgrace.
Thank you.